So we are going to be talking about the four different stages of posterior tibial tendonitis. And as a clinician, you really have to be able to identify at which stage your patient is in because they're treated very differently. So just as a recap, posterior tib is it is the only muscle that has some type of activity during the entire gait cycle, stance phase of the gait cycle. So at heel strike into full forefoot loading, and then at toe off or forefoot rocker, there is activation happening at posterior tib the entire time. So this tissue in particular has to be very resilient. The four stages of posterior tib tendonitis, the first two are going to be ones that you can rehabilitate. You work on foot strength. Versus stage three and stage four, you have to start looking at different interventions because that foot is gonna have some momentum on you. So with posterior tib tendonitis, go ahead and turn around for me, okay? Oftentimes what you're gonna see here is a foot that seems to be living in pronation, okay? The other thing that's kind of indicative of posterior tib issues is the too many toes signs. In other words, when you're looking at the heel from the back, you're gonna see too many toes because the forefoot is abducted, abducted. So you can see in this position how it looks like she's putting a lot of tension and stress on posterior tib. A way to assess this would be simply to look at a calf raise, okay? Stage one of posterior tib tendonitis, the patient is able to do a single leg calf raise with the rear foot inverting. Okay, so the forefoot is in one plane and the rear foot inverts. The inversion up at the top of the calf raise, that's post-tib. Okay, and as she comes down, what we want to see here is that she comes down with control. So if they have tenosynovitis or an inflammation at the tendon, they have pain, but they can still do a pretty calf raise, we're in stage one, we're rehabbing these guys. Okay, stage two, she's able to do the calf raise, but she can't invert the heel. Okay, so she comes up, but you don't see a lot of that inversion at the heel, okay? This is still functional. We can go after this. So this would be, go ahead and turn around again for me. Okay, a valgus looking foot. So in other words, this kind of pronated foot, okay? Or over pronated foot, I should say. In stage three, okay? So you'll have patients come in and their foot is gonna look like this. If they've been walking on this for many years, so these are gonna be your older population, what can start to happen is this will become a fixed deformity. So a fixed plano-valgus deformity. It's no longer flexible. Now we are stuck in this position. So stage three, she cannot do a calf raise. You'll see these patients, as they try to calf raise, they simply cannot do it, okay? And in which case, now we're looking at some type of orthotic and or brace. We like using the ASO braces. I'll even use the ASO brace in stage one and two, depending upon how inflamed the tendon is and how much pain they're in, okay? But stage three, we're definitely looking at some type of orthotic, okay? Stage four, and hope that you don't have too many patients there, it's what they sometimes want to do is have some type of surgical intervention. And that is, you know, ankle fusions and things like that. But definitely stage three and stage four, you're looking at an orthotic and oftentimes an ASO brace. Something else I wanted to mention with posterior tib issues is patients that will have an accessory navicular. Okay, so the accessory navicular is going to be an extra bone that lives off of the navicular. Okay, and you can see this on a film. Patients that have accessory naviculars oftentimes present with posterior tib tendonitis simply because of the vector of how the tendon has to come down the foot and have a wider angle as it wraps around the medial part of the foot to get underneath. So because of the distance traveled, right, it's gonna have a lack of blood supply. So with those patients, again, when you see that accessory navicular, you might want to go ahead and look at orthotic therapy as an early intervention for them.